Hello, Saberland.
Vader's Vault here, showing off another design in our line of mid-range sabers. Back in the summer, before Celebration, we released a line of three models of mid-range price sabers based around our Crystal Shard soundboard from Plector Labs. All three designs that we released at that time were received very well, and we had a lot of response to it and a lot of inquiries about them. About a month ago, I decided to release another batch. But before I could even bring them to the market, I had customers already contacting me about several of the models, the Haze, the Ember, and the Legacy models. So I was able to sell them all before I could even put them up for sale. And at the same time, I was also designing a fourth design. And this one I call Flare. And one of our good customers and good friends, Dave, C3PO on the forums, who bought Ember the second time around, asked if we had anything else in the mid-range line, and, well, I told him about this one and showed him the pics, and he took this one, too. This one I went with a little bit more detailing on the hilt, powder-coated with some parts lathed back off to give that contrast in colors. I did sort of a grip bar here, sort of to simulate either the bar graph or the clamp card on some of the OT sabers or the bar graph on the prequel trilogy sabers, but just something with a little bit more texture to it. But similar design element, but something that actually has texture. Then we got the back here with the lathed off round rings on the rear grip and the fatter pommel, and of course, the beautiful radiused flared emitter up here. Makes for an extremely comfortable grip, especially if you're like me and you like to hold the saber more towards the emitter end for more control. This makes for an extremely comfortable one-handed grip. This, of course, is based around our mid-range line with the singular tube chassis in the back, housing the single 18650 power cell and providing easy access to the grip, or to the SD card of the Crystal Shard. And I will show you guys that right now. Single 18650, easy to take out to either charge or replace the different cell to keep you going for hours at a time. Once the cell is out, it actually gives you very nice, simple access to the SD card right there. So you can go to www.saberfont.com and load it up with all your favorite sound fonts from all the best sound font makers in the industry and be ready to rock with the fonts of your choice. And this saber, I went with the Tri-Cree 9-watt and mixed for OSPP, Pression-Stopping Purplicious Purple, exclusive to Vader's Vault, for a very nice, bright, rich purple. And of course, with the white dye as the flash-on-clash, as the Crystal Shard supports flash-on-clash. Got a white dot anti-vandal switch here, providing the switch accent. And let's get it fired up in the dark and show you guys Flare.
This part is over.
Of course, that is Mace Windu, because what better to put on a purple saber than Mad Cow's Shatterpoint? And there is Tri-Cree OSPP in all its glory. Very, very bright, but yet still very rich color. Nice and even, too. We don't get any color separation. Especially in our blades, very even mix, and of course the very dramatic white flash on clash shows up back on the table, but I'm not going to bang the saber on the table really because it's glass. Hopefully that shows up on camera. Sometimes it doesn't because of frame rate, but in any case, it's flash on clash. You can't do without it. It's just the feature to have in a custom saber. But this is Flare. Maybe we'll see more of these. Maybe we won't. I don't know. It had a little bit more machining than normal on this line of sabers, so we'll just have to wing it, I guess. Thanks again from Vader's Vault.